Thank you for joining us. This session is part of our ongoing training series to help support your dealership operations. In this training, I'll walk you through how to receive inventory in IMS, either from an order you placed or from a transfer made between your dealership locations. The first step in receiving inventory is to locate the order receiving page. You can find this by going to the inventory drop-down menu in IMS and selecting order receiving. Once you're on the order receiving page, you'll see both new and historic orders that were placed in IMS. If you are receiving inventory from a transfer, you can also search by order number. Here's what you need to know. If an order status is listed as open, that means it's ready to be received. To receive an order, you'll click on the arrow icon under the Actions column for the order you want to process. Look for the arrow on the right-hand side for the order you placed and click it to get started. Next, you'll review the plate types being received and the quantity for each plate type. Click the serial number validation button to continue to the next step. Before moving forward, it's important to inspect your inventory to make sure everything is accurate. Double-check the quantity of license plates you're receiving and look for any damage or manufacturing defects. To review the individual license plate numbers, click on the menu icon next to the receiving quantity for each plate type. This will open a serialized pop-up screen that shows you all of the unique license plate numbers associated with that plate type. Take a moment to check for any missing, damaged, or defective plates compared to what IMS has listed. Verify that the plate numbers and quantities match what you physically received. If everything is correct, click the Save button to close the pop-up window. You'll then move on to the next plate type, repeat the same steps, and verify the inventory before completing the order. If you happen to have a discrepancy with your order, you can use the Flag Reason dropdown to report it. You'll select whether an item was not in order or if the item was damaged. Once you choose a reason from the dropdown, the flag icon will turn red to mark it. After you've either verified or flagged the inventory, click Save to close the pop-up window. Then, continue verifying the other plate types in the order if needed. After verifying each plate type, you'll then select the Facility Location button on the bottom right. Next, you'll see the Facility Location page. This page shows the location where the plates have been transferred. Simply click the Review button to move on to the next screen. On the Review page, you'll see a summary of your order. It will display the quantity of plates being received and the location they are being transferred to. Once you've reviewed everything, click the Receive Order button to finalize the transaction. If the transaction is successful, a confirmation pop-up will appear. Click Done to finish, and you'll be directed back to the order receiving page. From the order receiving page, you can click the View Order Detail icon, which looks like a little eye, under the Actions column. This will bring up the inbound receiving screen, where you can view a list of all the license plates included in the transfer. If you want to print out a receipt of the transaction, you can click the Print button, located at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. A printable receipt will automatically appear for you to review or print for your records. Here is an example of what the inventory order receipt looks like after printing. This receipt shows the details of your order, including the plate types, quantities received, and the location information. Now, go back to the home page because after receiving inventory, it's very important to confirm you have the correct license plates from that transfer. Best practice is to do this last step before physically moving the plates, so that the correct plates are what's being transported to this location. To do this, go to View Inventory under the Inventory drop-down menu. This will allow you to double-check the physical plates you received match what was transferred in IMS. Next, enter the P number for the location that received the inventory, then click Search to pull up the inventory for that location. Here in the In-Stock column, next to the quantity, click the triple lines button. This is where you can view the individual plate numbers that were transferred for each plate type. This is where you can confirm that the plates transferred are the correct plates brought from your other location. You'll want to go through each plate type you transferred and make sure all serial numbers match the physical plates you brought over. After you've verified that the plate numbers match what's listed in IMS, you're now ready to start issuing those plates at the destination location. And that wraps up this training. We covered how to receive inventory in IMS and print out the inventory order receipt. Locate our other IMS training videos on our YouTube channel or on our website. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next session.